Okay, very good morning to all of you. Here, now we are starting for our next division, PO Phyta. So I think the PO Phyta members, they are to be commonly found in the marine water maximum. And here you are observing the good photographs of different genera. So firstly, we will see about these. So Ectocarpus is the one known genera from the PO Phyta. Then there is a Spacellaria. It is also a very good genera. Then all we are knowing about the Sargassum. So this is a natural photograph of this Sargassum. Then Schistocera. It is also brown algae member. So then normally the member of PO Phyta, it is called as a giant kelp. Kelp, that is the, it looks like the forest. So this genus, it is having the Nereocystis lutecina. It is the largest genus. Then second genera is the Macrocystis, and the third genera is the Laminaria. So Laminaria is commonly called as the kelp. Then the one of the genera, mainly as it is showing the some conditions, as the PO Phyta, they are almost entirely marine, frequently dominating rocky shores in the cold and temperate waters throughout the world. So we are knowing our oceanic conditions are there, deep oceans, Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, right? So basically there is the maximum part generally. So therefore, and there is a open sea, pelagic, or the seashore areas, mainly they shows the their large occurrence. Nextly, the color of the brown, it is the predominant character of this particularly brown algae, and due to the brown accessory pigment fucoxanthin. You remember this pigment fucoxanthin, which cover a spectrum from the pale being to yellow brown to almost black. In the spectrum we are knowing the Vibgior, that is the violet in indigo, blue, G for green, Y for yellow, O for orange, and R for the red. So red light is having the maximum light intensity, whereas it absorbs the certain light. The tropical areas where the sunlight is reaching up to the depth of this, these forms are generally seen. Then filaments to the several meters in the length. This is the character. The size of these, they are from microscopic to the this one. The PO Phyta brown algae, some forms are the multicellular eukaryotic organism, that being the class from the PO Phyta. Commonly as about 1500 species, they are reported from the this one. Only out of the 6 are the freshwater. 99% are the marine water forms are there. In habitat also, as there is in the basically a maximum in the salt water. So freshwater organisms and the salt water, these are there. In freshwater organisms, generally they are solitary and non-motile. In characteristics, moreover, these are also commonly called as the giant kelp. You see the person in the central two photographs. So as these are the larger forms generally seen in the oceanic area, and it is having the Lophophora variegata. It is commonly found in the tropical waters. They may reach up to the 100 feet, that is 30 meter in the length. So the growth is very abundant, and it is showing the specific one. As it is a large group of algae, it consists 240 genera and about the 1500 species, out of which 32 genera and 93 species are reported from the India. They are commonly known as the brown algae due to the presence of golden brown xanthophyll pigment fucoxanthin. Formula is the CHO in the chromatophores. So mainly there are the chloroplast is absent, but the it is present in the form of chromatophores. So small granules are there. About 99.7% members are marine, and a few grow in the fresh water. The fresh water members like Pleurocladia, Hairy Bowdiella, then Pseudobodianiella, then Lithoderma, and the Spacellaria. You remember the names of these genera. So here, these freshwater members, they are the having the typical in the characteristic. Secondly, these members, Pleurocladia like, they grow both in the fresh and the marine habitat. Then in characteristics, the Phaeophysi members are there, we are knowing. So as they show the plant body is immobile, multicellular, and the highly differentiated, both externally and the internally. That is unicellular, colonial, motile and non-motile, and the unbranched filamentous forms. They are commonly absent. Then the range from the simple microscopic heterotrichous filament, for good example is the Ectocarpus, and to the largest algae Macrocystis, just we have seen the photograph, which attains the length of 60 to 90 meters. The largest forms are known as the kelps, which are commonly called as the rockweeds. Rockweeds, that is the, they are benthic, they are attached to the rocks. Then Lessonia is the one genus, reaches up to the length of 4 meters and looks like a miniature tree, Lessonia. Then Nereocystis is the genus, or the species is the Lulkeina, as it is showing the bladder kelp, which attains the length of 25 to 30 meter. Postelsia is the one genus, it looks like a palm, that is our coconut tree like habit. So as palms appears like a palm tree and commonly known as the sea palm, Postelsia. You remember specific genera and their characteristics. So here some photographs again are there. So as here they are knowing the Rapalacea is also genus there. Then secondly, their occurrence in the water. Then next one, good genera, as it is showing the seaweed, plant like brown algae, or the plant like body, or the thallus. Then thallus are typical algae, they are known. In morphology, the kelps are showing holdfast, stipe, and the blades are there. So morphology is typical, then other members are there. So this is total one thallus, holdfast at the base, then stipe, very strong bladder, which shows the storage of this particularly gases are there. And secondly, these are the line drawings for the kelps are there. So you may remember this. So this all genera. So here the A genera, it is having the Macrocystis. Here you are observing this one. Then B is the, it is the Nereocystis. Line drawing. This is the Nereocystis. C is the, it is the commonly the Postelsia, palm-like. C. You see the palm-like. And last one is the Laminaria. So Laminaria, it shows the air bladders on the deep like structure, or the stalk is there, it is called as the stipe. It is called as a stipe. So all these characteristics, these are very important, as we will remember for the today's lecture. Okay, we will see the next part in the next lecture. Okay, have a nice day.